the red and white scrimmage that, that Jim painted is so special to me, just to be a part of the program. Every time I look at it, you know, I kind of get inspired. You can see the guys that have set the program and lifted it up, raised the bar throughout the history of Cornell lacrosse. And every time I look, I just kind of see the excellence that, that those guys set. And I also just think back to working hard and being part of the program, and it kind of just, you know, inspires me to live up to their expectations.
Being my senior year, beating Princeton, obviously, in at the time what we called Georgie's House for George Briarty, something we played for all season. But for me as a senior, it was one of the most emotional games for me. Leading up to that game, you know, I had an opportunity as the sole captain that year to kind of address the guys on my feelings towards the game, towards Princeton, towards what we were trying to build for that season.
It was in front of a huge crowd. It was close to 10,000 people there. And it was just unbelievable. After every goal, just the roar was unbelievable. And there was one possession in the fourth quarter. It was a 6-minute offensive possession. When Max put that last shot in around the 6-minute mark, the Schoellkopf crescent just erupted. However, I do remember just going down, breaking my foot, finishing the play, and then going down and just being in excruciating pain. And the stadium was dead silent. My mom always would tell me that when I went down and the trainer came out and pushed on the spot where the bone had broken, I screamed, and the place was so quiet at the time that they could hear me clearly screaming from the field.
And chances, people tell you not to take chances.
This is George Briarty, someone who was close to the program, not someone who I got to know, but was on the team only a few years before I joined it, and kind of molded the team into what we were all about the field. Guys like Eamon McEnany, who also helped define our program and what we're all about. I would have loved to play with guys like Paul Schmoller. It's always nice to have, all-time greats in net. And then guys like Mike French and guys like Jonathan Levine, who won national championships. And in midfield, would have loved to run alongside Bobby Hendrickson, Hondo, as they called him, and Chris Kane, who won my number before I did.
To play with, I definitely have to say the attack from back in the 70s, guys like John Levine, Michael French, and even a little bit later on, Tim Goldstein. I'd love to play tack with guys like that. I'd really love to, some of my former coaches, Kyle Georgialis was a captain. I'd love to go against him, and also the current head coach, Ben DeLuca.
I am gonna stand my
ground. And I think it's cool how it just takes decades of Cornell lacrosse into one painting in a red-white scrimmage, which you've done so many times against your teammates, and you don't really think about what a red-white scrimmage would have been like if you took all of Cornell's lacrosse greats over the years. And I think that's what the painting does, and it really makes you think about what a game that really could have been.
If you look at a painting like this, and you just look at the program in general, it's all about the history and the roots of where we came from, and the goals that we've set together. I think going ahead, if we just stay true to that, that's going to spell good things for Cornell lacrosse in the future.
It's an honor for me to be in that picture alongside so many greats for Cornell. And again, just brings up those thoughts of what it would have been like to play alongside some of those guys. Fortunate enough to get to know a bunch of those guys in the picture. Become very close with some of those guys in the picture, actually. And also fortunate enough to have those guys around to kind of carry on the stories and the experiences they had with all those other players who are unfortunately not with us anymore, but mean a lot to the program and help define and lay their brick in the foundation of what Cornell lacrosse is all about today.
Let me see you stand.